Well, it's time now for our Ask the Doctor segment, and joining me now is Dr. Beth Collins. She's double board certified in plastic and reconstructive surgery. And today we're talking about an alarming new trend, human growth hormone. You've probably heard of it, but people are using it, and they say it's the fountain of youth. They look younger, their skin is tighter, they feel younger. It's really popular in Hollywood.
It's very tempting.
There's a strong warning with this as well. First off, let's just talk about what is human growth hormone.
Okay, well, human growth hormone is a hormone that's naturally produced in a person's pituitary gland. So it is responsible for lean muscle mass, some fat metabolism, and cell turnover. So it is sort of the feel-good hormone because it increases your lean muscle mass, it increases your metabolism, so that's where it gets kind of funny.
So that all sounds good.
Yeah.
And the FDA has actually approved it in some circumstances.
That's right.
Who is supposed to be using it?
So the first synthetic growth hormone was produced in 1985, and it is used primarily in children who lack normal production of the hormone, so they're not going to reach their normal growth potential. That's the most common use. It is used in some adults, for example, people who have muscle wasting from HIV infection, for example, or short bowel syndrome where they don't absorb their nutrients properly. But then it's a very narrow FDA-approved indication.
Okay, so what are the dangers of people who aren't a child and don't have their muscles deteriorating?
Right.
What are the dangers of someone that just wants to look 20 years younger?
Yeah, well, this is the thing, is that it does do all those things that you mentioned. It makes you feel a lot more energetic. It improves your sleep. It improves your lean muscle mass. Your metabolism is quicker. Your libido is better. But the problem with it is that it is doing this on a cellular level by increasing the turnover time of your cells to produce new and fresher cells. That's why it makes you feel so good. But the problem is, if you have a cell there that's not normal, like a cancer cell, for example, it's like throwing gasoline on the fire.
So it makes that double and grow it, as well.
Whatever it could do. And you really don't know if you have that in your background. The research is just really not out there that would say, first of all, that it has long-term beneficial effects. These things may be short-term. Also, that they don't know how many people are going to suffer those bad consequences. There are other things. It could thicken the heart muscle. It could give you brittle diabetes if you're using it improperly.
Right.
So right now, I think there are promising things about it, that it needs more research and more time. I wouldn't want to be the person who was trying this out on my body without knowing exactly what's going to happen in the long term.
Right. You don't want to look younger if it's going to kill you.
Right.
Obviously.
And it's
right.
Actually illegal, too. So if this
and there's that as well.
So if it's being prescribed by a doctor, you better be sure that you're under a controlled clinical study for it.
Right. Dr. Beth, great to see you as
okay.
always. And if you'd like to see more on this segment or any other segment when Dr. Beth is with us here on the couch, you can find them on our website at WTNH.com.